Period. Y'all bitches know we live. I'm a pippin nigga head straight to Ocean Drive. Period. Nigga, where the bag at? Nigga, where the what? Nigga, what? Nigga, where the bag at? Period. It's your boy, your host, Davion. Welcome to another episode of Conscious TV. I told you guys I was going to be kicking out these goddamn videos faster than IRS with a tax return, girl. This microphone life got me on fire. Now, I want to kick out some of these feel-goods, lighthearted commentary before I hit y'all with the seriousness of part two of that narcissism video, because it's going to be real heavy, girl. Y'all going to feel like y'all had to survive Conscious TV when it's all over. Anyway, comment, rate, subscribe, share, and hit that notification bell. You can also donate to the show at paypal.me/conscious TV and email me anything you want to at conscious TV@gmail.com. Let's get into it. So, girl, in one of my last posts, I asked you guys what you wanted me to cover in a Hot Topics video. So I checked into some of these stories, and indeed, girl, we got some things to talk about. So first thing on the docket is Tiffany, I Ain't Really Talented Haddish bumped epically on New Year's night. And when I say bumped on stage, I'm talking about Afghanistan, World Trade Centers, Vietnam, X-Men, The Last Stand, Oklahoma bumped on stage. Girl, I thought I was listening to a rehearsal of the real damn show, but this was the real damn show. Girl, this was a audition for the auditions. I was supposed to laugh at your comedy. Instead, I was laughing at myself, laughing at your attempt at doing stand-up comedy, girl. Niggas was walking out of your show quicker than a $20 fee at the Uncle Luke all-you-can-eat titty bar, girl. The fuck? Tiffany was up there talking about she be forgetting all the shit she wanna say once she get on stage. Girl, how about this? When we come to your shows, we forget to pay once we are seated. How about we decide if we wanna pay if you happen to remember your lines at any point during the show? How you forget your lines? Did you also forget that you were not a member of TLC? Cause you was dressed like crazy sexy and motherfucking cool at that show, girl. I thought Cat Williams hired Chicago's finest palm reader and had them hex your ass just so his insults towards you could be vindicated. Cause now everybody praising Cat Williams for his weather forecast. Girl, I thought I was watching the bitch open up for Tiffany Haddish, but it was Tiffany fucking Haddish. How you the opening act of your own damn show, girl? Now, to play devil's advocate, stand-up requires a talent all by itself. And just because someone is a comedian don't mean they are a stand-up comedian. Just like being a vocalist don't make you a songwriter, some comedians are only good in movies and sitcoms, just like some rappers are only studio rappers and not freestylers. Cardi B. And that's okay, because sometimes God only gives you talent in your throat and not in your damn hands. Didn't his word say his grace would be sufficient in your partial ass? Because we wouldn't even know just how good God has been to Tiffany if it wasn't for her failing so bad at stand-up. Because when you see that shit, you say to your damn self, if this talentless bitch could make it big and sit with Hollywood's finest, grossing millions of dollars in blockbuster movies, God is indeed good. See, when shit is too good, we start to think that the devil got something to do with it. Like, I'm blessing, get your too good to be true demonic ass away from me. But when there's just enough flaw and imperfection in something good, we feel just the right amount of worthiness and reliability. Okay. Now, before we move right along to our next class, it's also been reported that Tiffany is dating an older white man. Now, black women, I told y'all in my Section 8 video that y'all need to reclaim y'all times by raising the bar on who y'all willing to lay down with. And if these niggas can't seem to get their shit together, go out there and love who loves you. Even if that happens to be Jack, Connor, Duke, or Cody's ass. The pigment gonna leave y'all here waiting around for black men to be divorced by their first choice white women. Don't be there waiting for them niggas after they done chose everybody but you to finally wake up and smell the melanin that's been in their cups all along. Don't feel sorry for black men for giving black pussy to white dick. Them niggas will still have each other at least when the reconstruction period reemerges. They'll just have to figure out who's gonna bottom and top when it's all said and done. Go on and get you a good man, girl. Now, speaking of Cat I Only Smoke Weed Now Williams, V103 host Wanda Smith was fired like a week or two ago over a debacle involving her husband Bruce allegedly pulling a gun out on Williams and his entourage at a comedy show. Both the host and fellow comedian were attending, which was motivated by Cat Williams putting Wanda's self-esteem on death row after he roasted the toenail polish off Wanda's fingers, girl. Now, Wanda's husband Bruce was seen on surveillance footage exchanging Bojangles-flavored spit and words with Cat Williams before charging at the comedian who ran from the avalanche that was approaching him. Now, Bruce probably gave his life to Jesus after running after Cat Williams' ass because he hadn't activated the power of running since he was 7 years old. I heard he's now eating salads and taking daily baths as a result of the newfound confidence in the skinny him that's still alive, well, and kicking for air underneath them damn three bellies. Now, a lot of people blame Wanda for her husband's overreaction, and while I still agree that a man's natural response to a man insulting his wife even in good humor is still natural and understandable, that it should not have led to a physical altercation. Bruce should have just got online and roasted Cat Williams on behalf of his wife, who was in the kitchen making a mean-ass broccoli at the time. Now, while I don't think Wanda put her husband up to this altercation, I think him, as a husband, gave himself permission to be in his feelings about Cat Williams and decided that he was going to prove a point with or without his wife's approval. Now, y'all shouldn't find this so hard to believe, because if he clearly ain't respecting the junk food aisle at Walmart, how the hell y'all think he got the capacity to respect his wife's wishes? And while it's unfair for Wanda to have lost her job, it just reminds us that when we have something to lose in this world, we have to make sure the people around us is going to help us keep what we got. Because your team is just as important to your brand and your coin as you are. Now, Wanda, since you can cook such a mean-ass broccoli, I suggest you and your husband start a damn cooking channel, girl, because y'all look like y'all can cook some mean-ass mashed potatoes. Now, girl, let's talk about Candy Vibrating Vocals Burris and Tamar Bowling Ball Head-ass Braxton. Girl, I saw some more damn footage of Tamar from this season of Big Brother where she was speaking about the tension between her and Candy, and I was like, girl, I'm really starting not to like you, Tamar, and I really want to because you look so cute without no hair. But the way you internalize and interpret things, girl, be having my wig on the damn floor at all times. Tamar was telling us how she never understood why Candy didn't like her because she never did anything to Candy. They worked together on the tour and made coin together, but Candy never invited her to her home, and their kids never had a play date, and she just didn't get it. Okay, Tamar. Let me talk to your overt narcissistic ass daughter. Just because everyone you come into contact with not interested in kissing your ass and spit shining your damn head don't mean they don't like you, girl. Has it ever dawned on you that people like Monica and Candy are allowed to prefer you rather than automatically choose you? Has it ever dawned on you that you don't have to be everyone's favorite cup of tea and that some people prefer water over Mad Dog 22? The fact that you can form your lips to say that Candy don't like you because she never wanted to catch a hot play at OLG with you after work means she don't like you is indicative and a direct receipt of your immaturity and the improper development of your front cerebral cortex, girl. How many working class women go to work and have a cordial relationship to their fellow co-workers and have no interest nor feel obligated to nor ever have to make an issue of never having to see them hoes again after punching the clock, girl? Do you really think you're a likable person, Tamar? Iyala didn't even like you, girl. And if Iyala can't even bring herself to see past the nasty, vile, gutter snipe right about the hood-ass heifer in you, Tamar, then how anyone else gonna do it? Hell, Iyala got more Jesus than we do, and she ain't even casting her pearls before you. Tamar, I think your personality translates as a big-ass turd to the general public because you've become the Azealia Banks of the R&B world. You got more to say than to sing. I love that you are so colorful and march to the beat of a very flamboyant boy's iTunes playlist, but you talk more shit than show love. And while people love to watch a bitch, be a bitch, people never actually like that bitch. So showing the other side of you will help balance out the public's perception of you, girl. Y'all celebrity hoes really need me on y'all's team because y'all clearly don't be having the right PR people in y'all corner. Okay. Child, last but not least, B2K allegedly is gearing up to make a comeback after Raspy's underwhelming sex tape and will be headlining some shows around the Americas. Now, girl, people talking about these damn ticket prices, and I almost didn't believe my eyes until I put on my damn prescription reading glasses and was forced to. When I saw prices exceeding the $50 I expected to be at the highest for a boy band group that ain't had a hit since the knot on Cardi B's forehead, I wanted to take my damn wig off and slam it down on Tamar's fucking head. $4,000 and $5,600 for who, bitch? Y'all niggas ain't the Jackson 5. Y'all ain't boys and the men's. Girl, if I'm buying $600 tickets for a B2K concert, that better come with an hour and a half worth of dancing, along with a room at a five-star hotel equipped with a maid service, a helicopter drop-off point, an indoor pool, and all four of y'all's dicks laced with lube and a condom to pleasure me all damn night long. The fuck? Bitch, for $600, y'all getting me pregnant so that I can run to the courts 9 months later and get $6,000 child support checks a month and make my damn coin back. The fuck? Just look at it as an investment, girl. If I'm spending that kind of concert money on y'all, B2K them dance moves won't be the only thing getting bumped, bitch. For $600, I better be yelling, I think that I really like it, Ticketmaster.com better say B2K $600 floor seats, dick included. Anyways, y'all need to go check out Sparkle's interview on The Breakfast Club. For all y'all still wanting to defend R. Kelly's weak, I still like him in Pampers asses, this interview just reinforces y'all defending a guilty damn man. If y'all love R. Kelly and believe his innocence, tell that hoe to go prove it, girl. Tell him to go take a lie detector test regarding every allegation made by all the victims. Make him also take a STD test if he really doesn't have the herpes that one of the victims claimed he allegedly gave to her. Y'all defending this man, but watched him use the bathroom on a whole 14-year-old girl. And then watch his brother on TV say how R. Kelly allowed his lawyers to try to pin a sex tape on him as the man in the video. As if our own eyeballs don't see an H fucking D. The fuck? I wouldn't give a damn if both the brothers, along with every girl on the docuseries, along with the manager, the music producer, who testified against R. Kelly, all lied and made the whole damn thing up. Because what you can't defend is him having a sex tape out with a 14-year-old girl and a marriage certificate to Miss AJ, nothing but a number herself. And let me tell you also what the gag is. When Envy asked Sparkle about Aaliyah's mom's response to the allegations involving her daughter, Sparkle revealed to us that the girl who Mama Houghton said never breathed the same as her daughter was the same girl that sung background and rap throughout Aaliyah's first album all the way through from top to motherfucking bottom, and that they had a little girls click group amongst themselves and called themselves Three Chapters. But I bet your Mama Houghton ain't know that shit. since she was around every second of the damn day while Aaliyah was in the makings of stardom. Mama Hall and I ain't here for your ass either. I'm muting your ass too. Anyways, I'm getting out of here. I got shit to do and history to go make. Y'all make sure y'all comment, rate, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. Y'all can donate to the show at paypal.me/conscioustv and email me at conscioustv@gmail.com. Definitely leave me your opinions about what the hell going on out here in the world today, girl. Hope y'all are having a great hump day Thursday, whichever day this video goes up. And I'll talk to you guys later. Peace!